Science Day, and a great way to get kids excited about science is fun, experiments, hands-on, demonstrative. And Jennifer Gabries is the science chair at the Detroit Country Day Middle School. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks for getting up early on this National Science Day. So, Jennifer, why is it important for kids to get into this kind of stuff? I know everybody's on their tablets and devices, but why is this important?
Well, and there certainly is room for technology in science, but science is really helping kids make sense of the natural world, what's going on around them. And I think that kids are great at making observations. They're naturally curious. They want to know why. They want to ask questions. So doing this at home is a great way to spark that curiosity.
So let's get started. You brought a bunch of fun experiments.
I sure did.
I do a lot of these at schools too, and kids just really can learn a lot easier from them. Where are we going to start?
Well, you know, the great thing about all of these are things that you're going to do at home, because you probably have most of these things at home.
Right.
So I'm going to start down here, and I'm just going to have some Skittles on a plate here, and you can talk to kids about making patterns.
Oh.
And you just, you know, go to the store, get some Skittles, put them on a plate, see
those
what
weren't
happens.
For me. I thought maybe.
Those are not, I might have some left over.
So
when
we're pouring
done.
Water on the Skittles.
Yeah, and then we're just going to let that. Sometimes science takes a minute, so we're just going to let that sit down. But come on down here.
Right.
I have, I took a purple cabbage,
ooh,
boiled it. This is kind of leftover purple cabbage.
Looks wonderful.
And the juice comes out this way, and it's like a dark blue kind of purple color, but it's got a neat property about it. It's actually a natural indicator. So I brought some just common things. I put a little cabbage juice in here, and if you want to go ahead and just give a little squirt or a little pour of each of these.
I better put these on.
Yeah, safety first,
come on.
For sure.
Ooh.
So go ahead and put a little squirt of these, and we're just going to see what happens when we put some common chemicals in purple cabbage juice.
Wow. All right. So am I pouring lemon juice?
Nope. Now you want to try this one here. So try the Sprite. Let's see what happens when you pour Sprite in here. All right.
Ooh, all right.
A little
the
bit
purple.
Different. Yep. So we have got some
saline
solution, right? You might have to pour that one a little bit. How much of a change? A little bit of change, but look.
That's
so
a
we
nice,
can start talking
purple.
To kids. What happens when we do this? And you know, you might have kids say, you know what? I'm going to go to my closet. I'm going to find something in the pantry that gives some sprays to that one and see what happens. This one's pretty
ooh.
Neat. Yeah. So we have
cool.
some color changes going on here, and you can talk to kids about why that happens, and they might just go find some more stuff to try it with.
Awesome.
All right. So this one's kind of neat here. I've got some regular peroxide in a bottle. I'll give it a little squirt of dish soap. And in here, we've got some yeast going. So, Brandon, I'm going to have you pour that in here. You can get it right in that bottle.
The
pour
yeast
that in
and
there.
Water?
Just yeast and water, yep. And
okay.
we'll see what happens here. So go ahead, pour. And we're going to move this
heads up,
out of the
heads
way.
Heads up. So. I got my goggles on.
So we have this what? Here. But, you know, so now this is now perfectly safe to use. So not only do we have what's happening here, but kids can play with this.
Oh.
You can feel it. It feels out. Why don't you? Can you feel that a little bit? I know it's a little messy. What does it feel like?
Well, it's warm and it's
right.
It's like it's a I don't know foam almost.
Foam. We've got some foam going on. So we talk about chemical reactions. We can talk to older kids about what happened there and
high
why
five
did it make
me on
warm.
That one.
No, I'm gonna pass.
Okay.
I have some napkins here for you right here. All right, so here I have just milk, and I'm going to put some food coloring in this milk. The higher the fat content, the better. So if you have some whole milk
half
around,
and half.
Right. And I've got some here, and you can see that
ooh,
not
cool.
much is happening.
Right.
But if you take one of those Q-tips
okay.
and you dip it on
the color.
Food coloring, what happens? Nothing.
Yeah.
No, don't swirl.
Oh, don't swirl.
Nothing exciting.
Just
okay,
dip
now,
it?
Yeah, now take yours and dip it in this soap right here.
Okay.
And go ahead and put it back onto those little dots of food color we've got there. And you can
oh.
see
whoa.
We've kind of got a color explosion going on as those as that soap is chasing those fat molecules around and pushing around the food coloring.
Oh, neat. My foam is getting all over it.
Right, here you go.
Oh, there you go.
All right,
thanks.
We've got some more stuff. I got one more way for you to get messy in a
all
second.
All right.
But here I have some Skittles on a plate, and we just made a pattern. We poured some water on here, and you can see kind of a neat pattern that these Skittles are making with
straight
the
up dye, water
straight
and
up water and Skittles. So why is that happening? That's a question, right?
Yeah.
Some other things that you can do at
that's,
home. I've
that's
got
awesome.
Some cars made out of recycled materials. We've got a juice box. We've got Girl Scout cookies.
Jason
I'm not telling
Carr
you where the cookies
today.
Went.
That might be his
balloon
box.
Straw. So what's going to happen when we blow this up and we can race it across? Have a race with your sibling. Recycle things at home. That's a great way.
That is awesome.
That's right. Some other things that you can do. You know, you can get kids outside. There's a great app for birding with kids. Any kid can use this app. It's called Merlin Bird ID. It's great fun for kids to do. Your brother's soccer game. Your son or daughter gets bored. They can pull this up and identify some birds.
Jennifer Gabries from the Detroit Country Day Middle School. Thank you so much for
you're
coming
welcome.
In. As we send it back to you guys, a little tornado in a bottle. Can you see it?
Thank you.
Thanks, Jennifer. Great job. Happy National Science Day.
Science is every day.